came from attending All Souls Day Mass in Inaraha, and we were talking about you because of this hearing that happened on Friday, Bree.
No, it happened on Saturday afternoon. It was a hearing for the public health fines and fees, and there was some dead area during the hearing, and you had said, hey, let me just start up a conversation here. Let's have a conversation. And you had mentioned the possibility or something that you had heard about a lockdown, a 48-hour lockdown. And what can you tell us about that? Where did you hear that from? Was this anything official?
No, it's nothing official. I had conversations with some folks from the medical community. There's a lot of tension about the proliferation of the virus. There's a possibility. I'm sure it's been tossed around about possibly one of those shelter-in-place, stay-at-home rules. I even heard talks of curfew. And so I just wanted to ask representatives of the administration if that was within the intent of those rules that were being put forward. And if you recall, in the early part of this year, many of us spoke out against that. You know, we don't want the virus to spread. At the same time, it's ridiculous if you're going to require us to stay within the four walls of our home. There's adjacent mm-hmm. properties. We can play football. I just heard the administrator of GMH encouraging us to go outside and stay safe and stay sane. Mm-hmm. And so if there's a lot of ambiguity, that leaves way too much opportunity for abuse of power. And so I support the fines if people are egregiously violating these provisions. But if it's not clear, there's too much room for a runaway, in my opinion, runaway enforcement.
Mm-hmm. Right. What I thought was kind of awkward was seeing the legislature testifying during this virtual public hearing as opposed to running this public hearing.
I typically defer to the committee chair, just a matter of protocol and respect. And I reached out to my colleague, Senator Talahi. I said, hey, Senator, I have some serious concerns. Can I go ahead and send that to you on a side chat and we can talk? And she goes, this is actually a public health hearing. And I was just taken aback. It's very interesting that the legislature would be a guest as opposed to be a partner. I just don't understand that. I'm hoping that they can reach out to the speaker and the ruling majority or the minority leader, and we can have some real discussions on the back end. This is it's awkward. It was and it's awkwardly dangerous, I think, for democracy in general.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, I saw Senator Teresa Talahi. She actually was in the Zoom room and in the public hearing, but like Senator, I think Talataitagui, both kind of deferred from commenting. They just really wanted to hear what people had to say, and then I guess Wednesday is the next hearing, and I guess we'll see if any of the senators will testify at that time. Is that something you plan on doing?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm looking forward to the answers to the questions I put forward, like how do you define a stay-at-home rule? And someone said essential work or travel, going for food, and one other thing. And so what I didn't see there was room for stepping out of the house and into your property to exercise. You don't know how far they can take this. And that's our job as a third and equal branch of government, to make sure there's no abuse of authority. Frankly, I'd like to talk with my colleagues offline and see what we can do to kind of reel some of that in. And I'm sure that's going to happen after the election. It's just something's awkwardly dangerous here. It's I've never seen it. I don't know how you set rules without us in place and suspending the AAA process, but I know the intent is good. The doctors and the surgeon cell really want us to contain the virus. I just think there's a better way to do it.
Was there a meeting last week with the surgeon cell in the legislature?
I can't confirm if it was last week, but typically the speaker has done a great job attempting to get us to meet with them and have a discussion about some of the data. It's very regular, and so I thank them for that opportunity. But in terms of these rules and promulgations, I had first look at it just a couple of days ago. And you're right. I just thought it was awkward to have dead space. And so I asked some questions, very basic questions.
Right. All right. Well, thanks a lot, Senator Castro, for coming in. I just really wanted to get clarification on this whole lockdown thing, but also just to hear some of your concerns with this public hearing. And
everyone come out and vote and be safe. Thank you, guys. Thank you for the opportunity.
Did you vote already, Senator?
You bet I did. I did.
It's kind of weird going into election day and having already voted. I feel impotent.
Well, you know, I tell you, it's interesting. I mean, I another show, I'd like to talk about this whole cancellation of the primary.
Yeah.
But every satellite opportunity we had, they were showing up, walking up and down. So I just don't get it. I just don't get it.
Yeah. Yeah. So, yeah, after the election, we'll definitely get you on and, you know.
Election night.
Thank you.
Election night. All right. Stay up.
I sure will. I look
forward
to it.
Stay woke.
I look forward to it.
Stay woke, like Sabrina said.
Yeah, thank you. That's thank that. You.
Okay,
you guys
all right.
On,
okay. Thank you. There you go. Good luck. Good luck. There you go, Senator Will Castro. It's 9:02.